He's been dubbed the polyvegan soldier, training hard to defend the front line. But for the past few years, he's been expanding that role on the front line of another kind, defending animals from abuse in New Zealand rodeos.
Never had enough of seeing animals stressed, scared, just for the sake of human entertainment.
Apollo Taito's path to animal rights campaigning began when he decided to become a vegan relatively late in life, thanks to his wife, Helena.
I've been vegan for about 8 years now. Yeah, so probably just around my 40s I started, just sort of tested, trialed things out. And it really was just a test and adjust to see how I liked it.
So how come you're using the coconut oil skit?
Coconut oil, actually one of the only plant foods that have saturated fat. So in that sense, it gives us that richness that you would get from meat.
My wife was a heavy influencer about me becoming vegan, and she was quite smart. So she just brought out the right resources around some of the research. Once your eyes open up to some of the myths around eating animal products, you just really start getting an understanding about how much you've been in the dark.
Making changes at home was one thing, but how would he cope being a vegan in the army where he holds a staff sergeant's rank in the territorials?
I think people get quite surprised when I tell them I'm vegan, definitely in my role in the army. They ask, oh, I can't be vegan just eating veggies, look how big you are. And they're really good around supporting my vegan lifestyle or life. There's always a meal for me. If I don't have a meal, then they'll hurry up and try and get something for me. Last time they begged to give a whole lot of lettuce or something like that, and they put down vegan with a big heart, love them.
Apollo now heads the anti-rodeo campaign started by the animal rights organisation Direct Animal Action. On this day, the protests are in the Waikato.
It's just part of our campaign to bring to light the fact that this rodeos, exploitation of animals, still occurs in New Zealand. We're just asking the government to fulfil their obligation around banning the worst aspects of rodeo. So some of the worst aspects is tail twisting, and it's where they twist the animal's tail to get them real fearful in that. So when they open the gate, they just take off. Same with an electric prodder. So they use an electric prodder to get them agitated, get them painful, get them fearful, so when they open up against the gates again, then they just take off. Another item that's quite popular in rodeos is the flank strap. And it's a piece of leather that's tied around the abdomen of the animal. It's tied up real tight. That causes a discomfort, pain, and that's where they get the bucking sensations.
It's made Apollo determined to get other people questioning where they stand when it comes to the exploitation of animals.
We grew up very much influenced and conditioned by, you know, our culture, our society, and the norm is eating meat. And I think that norm is so much that we ignore the fact that the meat comes from where animals are exploited, they're hurt. And I think that's the main thing about being an ethical vegan. You just know that, you know, that there's a reason why you decide to be a vegan, and it's about the animals, yeah.